I'm going to show you how to cleat a line. There are three things to think about when you're cleating a line. Number one, you should always be able to free a line under load. Number two, you don't want the line to get pinched. If you have the wrong lead and it's not a fair lead, then your line will get pinched on the cleat and it will be hard to take off. And number three, it should always look good. The first turn on your cleat should have a proper lead, meaning it should have an open V. Take a look here. This is an open V. The V with the cleat and the rope. This is an improper lead. This is a closed V. Even if I went like that, this is gonna pinch on this line. Okay, so let's do it right. You want your first turn to make the letter C around your cleat, then you do some figure eight wraps. And the last one, you do a locking hitch. You turn the line on itself over the horn, and these two lines lie side by side next to each other with a third line over top. Adding more locking hitches does not make your knot any stronger. If you need to have a lot of holding power, add more turns, but not more locking hitches. You want to be able to easily undo your cleat, and if you've got the locking hitches down at the bottom of the stack, and that's where the load-bearing hitch is, then that's going to tighten down on itself and be really hard to undo. How many turns do you put around your cleat before you put the locking hitch on? Well, it depends on how much load you have. If it's a really light wind day and you've got a small boat, you only need to do a few, but if it's a really strong wind, the more turns you add, the more friction and the more holding power you have.